Hey, this is DJ from DJ's Trains on YouTube. We are going east above the CSX main line, former Baltimore and Ohio line, through the historic town of Dawson, Pennsylvania. We are about 5 miles from our destination, Connellsville. The small town of Dawson has a lot of beautiful old buildings like this one. You're also going to find a lot of really well-maintained homes. And if you look closely, along the tracks you'll find a cute little antique store. Now from here until Connellsville Yard, the main line snakes through the woods and alongside the Youghiogheny River. The scenery is beautiful. Track speed through the town is 30 miles per hour. There are 6 road crossings, which provide plenty of opportunities for rail fanning. We'll be covering Connellsville Yard from west to east. Ironically, no signal is called Connellsville. The interlocking on the west end is called Sodom. Now looking east at the Sodom signal, the signal on the far right is for number 2 main, the middle signal is for number 1 main, and the signal on the left are for trains coming off of the Wheeling and Lake Erie Railroad main line. The track furthest away is number 4 main. There is not a signal for it at Sodom because we use it as a switching lead. So here we see an eastbound. Nowadays it is very common to see only one engine up front and a engine in the middle of the train as distributed power. We'll see that in just a few minutes. So here the train is passing one of the many old abandoned buildings that we still have on the property. Now this yard is very old and at one time was a hump yard. Now there's been so many tracks that have been ripped out, so the numbering of tracks is very confusing. If you look at the map, it doesn't make a lot of sense, but probably back in the day it did. So I'm just going to say there's basically 2 yards. On the right hand side, along the river, we'll just call this the river yard. These are our long tracks. And now this is where it's most common to see the long cuts of auto racks. It is double-sided, meaning there are switches on both ends. The track that goes basically through the middle of the yard is 103. Very confusing, I understand. Now there we see the distributed power going by. Got one unit in the middle of the train. And here towards the left, we're going to see a couple different things. We're going to see 2 very long tracks. There's auto racks on one of them, and they go pretty much the length of the yard. And then we're going to see a handful of tracks right here that have yard power and just miscellaneous freight. Now those tracks right there with the miscellaneous freight are stub-ended. We don't keep a lot of cars there. That's usually what we interchange with one of 2 railroads, the Southwestern Pennsylvania Railroad or the Wheeling and Lake Erie. There's a lot of buildings that are for the maintenance of way department. And by the open space, you see where there used to be a lot of tracks at one time. Now the yard job is RCO, which is for remote control units. There is not an actual engineer. This is the conductor with a remote control belt pack, and he controls the engine. They work as either one-man crews or sometimes 2-man crews. Traffic is extremely slow as the filming of this video during the pandemic. Now if you look off to the left, you'll see some red structures. That is called Stone and Company, and there's just a little tiny spur track. If you look carefully, you see it. just as a little hand throw that comes off the main. Very, very rare will you see something stored there. Maybe just a maintenance of way car or something. So this is the west end of the yard. And here in the middle of the yard is where you'll find the crow's nest. That's where we keep our yard master up there. He gets a good view of the whole yard. It's also where the crews meet and go over our paperwork. And now we'll start to head east. Now these tracks, we used to call these the helper tracks. There are no longer manned helpers, so this is where we keep our distributed power, extra engines, and even our maintenance away trains. Now, the signal for the east end of Connellsville is called Green Junction. It's going to be a little bit out of view, but all these tracks will converge into three tracks, one main, two main, and four main. Four main will go about another mile and a half and connect back onto two main. That'll be out of view. But at least here you get a pretty good idea of the location of the yard at Green Junction and this beautiful scenery around it. Now I'm going back into the middle of the yard because I know you saw the map and you saw what used to be our turntable. Well, the turntable's still there, but it hasn't been used, I would say, at least 20 years. In the early 1900s, there was a five-stall roundhouse, which burned down around 1928. The red building behind it, we called the Safety Palace, and that's where a lot of our training takes place. Now we changed location with the drone, and we're going to look at Green Junction headed west. From this angle to the left is four main, then two main, then one main. Four main is where we normally store trains, such as the coal trains that are waiting to go east towards Cumberland. Now here's a beautiful shot of Green Junction and the old tower that's now abandoned, and this track that curves and goes off across the river is for the SWP Railroad. This used to be the B&O Sheepskin. Both Green Junction and Sodom, all the signals are controlled by the BA dispatcher. If you look closely at the roof, I believe there are tires holding the roof down. So the Youghiogheny River is to our left. The SWP Bridge goes across and heads towards Uniontown. Now the other side of the river is the bike trail, and this will take you from Pittsburgh all the way to Washington, D.C. if you choose to do it. And you can see pillars where this was probably once a Y. Interesting footnote about this area, right below us where this is woods, used to be where they stored cattle. There were some tracks and they would store the cattle trains and water the cattle cars. And it's hard to tell from this angle, but we're headed east, and this is where the hill starts. This track will eventually go over that mountain. It is no joke, trust me. Very steep grade, but that is where you'll see Sand Patch, and the tracks continue all the way to Cumberland, Maryland. Now, speaking of steep grades, if you go up this steep hill, there was a track. It's abandoned now, but you can see some track There was a switch that came up this hill and went to anchor hocking glass. I never got to run on this, thank goodness, but this looked like a pretty good 3% grade into the old glass plant. And here's where we're going to wrap things up for the Connellsville Yard video. If you like this video and you want to see more, please subscribe to my channel, DJ's Trains, where I have hundreds of videos which teach how the railroad works, lots of prototype information, how to model it, stories about life as an engineer, and so much more. You can also check out my website, djstrains.com, and follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.